are set to go with our feature matchup here on the Power Hour, and we are awaiting the arrival of two of the biggest and baddest in World Championship Wrestling, and two men who are certainly, led by Harley Race, looking for some revenge. The Colossal Kongs, namely King Kong, making his way to the ring. This will be a tall order for the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
And a wide one, too.
Yes.
What's this guy weigh, 500 pounds?
Every bit of it, on a good day.
How do you weigh somebody like that?
Very carefully.
Yeah. How much do you weigh?
Whatever I want.
King Kong, who was disposed of by the Shockmaster. All right. Here he comes, the 11-time heavyweight champion of the world, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. What a tremendous matchup he had at Starrcade against Vader to become world champion. And there's Fifi back on his side.
Don't look at her. Get in the ring, Flair, and do what you do best.
People may be wondering where Fifi was at Starrcade, and I have it on good authority that just in case Flair won, she was helping prepare the celebration party afterwards that you attended, didn't you?
Yeah. Hey, how often in somebody's life can you say you saw somebody do something the 11th time? I mean, Ric Flair is the greatest wrestler of our time, and you're darn right I was at ringside watching, not at real close, but not as close as you.
It was an event, and fans, we invite you to call the WCW Wrestling Hotline tonight until midnight for Mean Gene Okerlund. He'll be talking a lot. As a matter of fact, he talked to some of the former world champions about Flair's reign and got their opinion on it. So give Mean Gene Okerlund a call tonight on the hotline. And Gene even talked to, I understand, Hulk Hogan and got his opinions on Flair's win.
Well, you know something, Hulk, I'm maniacs.
Is that what he said?
That's good. That's one of your better ones. We are set to go as Ric Flair will be going up against... Whoa, look at this double axe handle. King Kong. Kong wasting no time going on to Flair, and immediately thumbs down from the fans as Flair's getting worked over here.
Yeah, you don't think Harley Race knows Ric Flair inside and out, do you? He knew exactly what to do to get Ric upset. Oh! Oh! 500 pounds. How much punishment can Ric Flair take, especially after Starrcade?
And Harley Race wasting no time.
Harley Race hates Ric Flair's guts, let's be honest, and he'll do anything he can to destroy him. Hate's a real strong word, but I think that's what goes on between Flair and Race.
Of course, it was the first Starrcade. We've said it countless times. Flair became world champion for the second time. It was Harley Race's last title reign. And Race wasting no time again. Referee talking to King Kong. Oh, head first to the ring post.
Wow. My goodness, Ric Flair right here. I don't know. He doesn't know. Is it safer in the ring or out? Harley Race is running his head into that steel pole. 500 whatever pounds dropping elbows on you. Ric Flair's got nowhere to go. Smart move by Kong, though. He's got Flair on the ropes, and he just hangs. When I say on the ropes, he's got him in trouble. Works that bear hug to drive the wind out of Ric Flair because all he's got is his skill and his speed. You take away that air, there is no speed.
Flair pounding away on the big guy. Ric Flair hit the ropes and then hit the mat.
I guess this guy, this King Kong, is ready. I mean, Ric Flair, you might be a little intimidated thinking you're wrestling the greatest wrestler of all time. I think Kong's here to destroy a dynasty. When you're the greatest wrestler in the world, what do you do with a guy that's bigger than a grizzly bear? Grab an arm bar?
Stay away from him. Hit and run.
But that's one thing about Ric Flair. If anybody can beat this guy, Ric will find a way.
Again, Harley Race taking his shots, and Harley Race wasting no time. He is hitting each and every time on the outside. It's been a plan here.
Yeah, it really makes me mad because I'd like to see a contest between these two guys so he can showcase Flair's skills. Harley Race is just making sure that doesn't happen. Ugh. How much more can anybody take? this kind of punishment. 500 pounds. There's nowhere to go in that turnbuckle.
Oh, but that doesn't stop Flair.
Where does he get it? Where does he get that second win?
Conditioning. He has always said that he was a 60-minute man. Well, 30 minutes with Vader the other night was like 60 minutes. Oh, bad move. Went to pick up the big guy and...
Yeah, you get that adrenaline flowing. You get into a flow and you think, well, God, I got to go my way. I'll slam this big guy and maybe go for the figure four. Too much bulk. Girth.
Here he goes.
Ric Flair's out. Greatest conditioned athlete in our sport, maybe of any sport. No matter what anybody dishes out to this guy, he keeps coming back just like that.
Oh!
Look at the welts on Kong's chest from those chops. He knocked him down with a chop. Go, Nature Boy! Can you tell who I want to win?
Yeah, you're one big cheerleader.
Yeah, I appreciate great work and great talent. That's Ric Flair. Caught his balance. Great move.
He came down on top of the bit. Holy race!
Do it, Nature Boy. Don't let him get up. Just keep chopping him.
That's exactly why. He's helping him up. It's going to help him up to knock him down again. Wow, it's a Terry Taylor five arm.
That was a three arm. He hadn't quite got that technique down like me. He is on fire here.
And he comes off the top. And he's ready for the figure four leg lock.
Can he get it on a guy whose legs are size of tree trunks? He got it. Here, Kong in pain screaming.
That's it. Ric Flair, the world champion, is your winner for the 11th time. It's the champion. And here comes Harley Race.
I don't blame Flair. Harley Race stuck his nose in too many times. He dispatched two guys in one match. And he enjoyed doing it. You see how happy he is? He loves what he does. He loves being the best.
And he is the best. The Nature Boy continues his winning ways. The world champion, like we said tonight, some footage from Starcade on his way.
Flair gets up to the top, uses that momentum. Boom, wallops Kong on top of the head. I never thought in a million years he'd get these big chubby legs together like that, but he did it, and he got the submission. Ric Flair, 11 times champion, the greatest of all time.
Be sure to join us tonight at 6:05, and we'll see parts of that classic matchup, Flair and Vader. Flair's your winner of the Power Hour.